first, which is Evolution of Delhi University. Evolution of Delhi University by Dr. Seema Guru.
The joke goes in my family that except my mother, our mother-in-law, including my father, my father-in-law, myself, my husband, siblings on both sides, their spouses are undergraduates, postgraduates, MPhils, doctorates, MBBS doctor, BTEC in IT, and MBA from various colleges ranging from Stephens, SRCC to Shyamlal and Shraddha, from Daulatram to Deshbandhu, from FMS to Delhi School of Economics. I myself has been student of University of Delhi, popularly known as DU, since last 20 years, which came into effect by Special Statute Act 1920. Today, I'm going to tell you about the evolution of various colleges before 1922 and its association with freedom struggle. The oldest college, the Delhi College, came into existence during the reign of Aurangzeb and started originally as Madrasa. With the fall of Mughal Empire, the effervescence in education also came to be destroyed. When East India Company took over Delhi and showed its interest in education, Delhi Oriental College was established and subjects like English, mathematics and sciences were introduced. Lord Amherst has visited this college in 1827 and Lord Bentinck had visited this college in 1832. There is an interesting anecdote which goes about this college during that time. You must have all heard about the legendary poet Mirza Ghalib. He applied for the post of Urdu teacher in this college and for interview he came in his palanquin and he expected that he should be received at the gate of college by Mr. Thompson. So you must be wondering, who is Mr. Thompson? Mr. Thompson was secretary to the government of India, who was later appointed as Governor General to Northwest Frontier Province, and he had come to Delhi for interview in candidates who had applied. Since it did happen, Mirza Ghalib went back without giving the interview, and Delhi University lost its association with Mirza Ghalib. This college later on became the focal center for the activities of anti-Britishers, and the building was occupied by British troops till 1872, and this building also suffered heavily during the partition of 1947. This college is presently known as Zakir Hussain College. Another college, Ramdas College, was established by Rai Bahadur Kedar Nath in 1917 and started from Anandpur. Do you know that during Second World War, this college building was requisitioned by military academy and was given back only in December 1946, just few months before India attained independence. St. Stephen's College started as missionary school in 1853-54 from rented two-room in a building called Sheesh Mahal in Kushal Raika Patra near Kinari Bazaar, opposing to existing Central Bank building in Chandni Chowk. Do you know that Rabindranath Tagore visited this college and gave lecture on nationalism on 3rd October 1914 and finalized English translation of his book Gitanjali, which won him Nobel Prize later, in the house of Principal Rudra of St. Stephen's College. As the country experienced turmoil and fervor of nationalism was on high at the end of 19th century, due to anti-education policies of Lord Curzon, few rich and respected businessmen of Delhi came together, initiated and instituted Hindu College. Do you know that this college had the blessings of Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Annie Besant, the college has been visited by Gandhiji and Nehru. The corridors of the college is witness to the Khilafat and non-cooperation movement and other nationalist movement till India achieved its independence. The story of the University of Delhi begins in 1911 when Emperor V made an announcement that the capital of Imperial India would be transferred from Calcutta to Delhi. The principals of various colleges including St. Stephen's, Hindu, Rajas and from Delhi Oriental College, they drafted and made a proposal for the university which should be established in Delhi. But unfortunately, First World War broke out in 1914 and this proposal was shelved. At the end of war in 1918, this proposal was revived and after deliberate discussion, finally a DU bill was introduced on 16 January 1922. It was passed by Legislative Assembly on 22nd February 1922, by Council of States on 28th February 1922. The bill was given its consent by Viceroy on 5th March 1922 and an act came into force on 1st May 1922 after notification to this effect was signed by Governor in Council on 6th April 1922. Then Viceroy Lord Reading was the Chancellor, the post which is now held by President of India. Sir Dr. Hari Singh Gaur was the Vice Chancellor. He is the first Vice Chancellor of Delhi University. Do you know that to begin with, the University of Delhi has no building on its own? Can you make a guess from where it started? Sir, it started from Red Cinema Building. You must be knowing about it from Kashmiri Gate. And people say that at that time the area was infested with snakes. There are lots of stories and anecdotes, but I would like to end the story with a lighter and romantic moment when a young lady named Edwina visited the Viceroy Regal Estate and was proposed by a young officer in British Army. Who would have thought that Vice Chancellor Office of Delhi University and room number 103 of Registrar Office has been witness to the marriage proposal by Lord Mountbatten to the lady Edwina. The young officer later on became the last Viceroy of India and first Governor General of Independence.